Hey guys, it's Davey again. Right, now this is a let's build of the sanctuary houses, because I keep getting requests on how to build the roofs. Now, that building we just took a look at before, the one opposite your main house, is not going to be the focus. I wanted to show you it so I could point it out. The reason being is it's the one building in the entire settlement that's an absolute bitch to actually build up. We're building the one I just wandered to a second ago. So we're starting with the floors. I have shown this before in my second ever video. However, a lot of people are kind of claiming it doesn't work for them and that kind of thing. So I thought it'd be prudent just to kind of go through the steps again, possibly as well because since that video I've gained quite a few new subscribers. And it just kind of demonstrates that it is in fact still working. My game has been updated. So as you see right now, we're doing the floor little system again. So I put down the boards on the floor first, then the wall, then the roofs, which I'm using the upper floors. Now, to reiterate why I put the boards down the floor first, for some whatever reason, if I don't do that, when you go to move, to use the rug glitch to move the ceiling into place, it doesn't work. It seems to sink. So I then put the little board on there, and then I can place that in a nice clean corner. I pop the ladder on, because I like making sure all the lights blocked out as much as possible. I do triple board it, basically. Now, I didn't explain this clearly, I don't feel I did in the second tutorial, but basically, notice I'm putting them in the center first. The reason being is if you put them on, tried to put these boards on the corner, they will fly out and it'll be a complete nightmare. So I highly suggest when you do that to just start from the center. I'm quite quick at doing this, as you can see. I've done it a few times. Yeah, so basically just do the rug, hold the X button on the rug, and then voila. I did check out a corner first. I'm gonna pop it in that corner there. You see, I just kind of slot it in using the wall and the board as a kind of gauge into how straight it is, and it is perfect. There are, you will notice, a couple of, it happens with all the buildings, so it is unavoidable. There are a few gaps, right, you see there? That's unavoidable. Unfortunately, you could put another board on, but it would then be too long, and you'd have parts poking out. So now I'm going to do the doorway. I actually do the doorway twice, because I don't do it properly. Now, quick note, because obviously there is another way to do the doorway. A lot of people are mentioning in my kind of second tutorial that, yes, you can actually remove that frame and then use the rug glitch to actually kind of move the, I guess, floating door in. I've done it before, but the thing is the doorway does look a bit better when I do it the second time. I was just rushing this to kind of get it in so I could use it as a gauge for where I was doing those windows. But basically, I just prefer, because I put a lot of kind of scrap and wood over the houses, I just like having this effect. And also, right, I redo the doorway right at the end. I just like the look of what I do with the doorway, because I basically build a little platform in front of it. It looks quite grand, but ultimately the choice is yours. You see, the reason why is I noticed that it was already poking out. However, I'm going to use that as a gauge, because I'm going to put the windows in next. I wanted to make sure the room for the doorway was there first, so that way it doesn't, I don't do all the walls and all the block up all the windows and then proceed to not be able to put the doorway in. It would just piss me off. Now, I decided in this one, because I wanted to experiment, normally I use the those kind of flat boards. Instead, I decided to use the scrap metal walls, so the corrugated steel, just because I wanted to try something different. It ended up looking quite cool, actually. I was quite surprised. I thought it would look pretty shit. But the good thing about those walls is they're really, really thin as well, so you can just squeeze them in. All grand. You see what I'm doing there is I'm actually having that one I fucked up, which is good. I like leaving the fuck ups there, but basically I'm using the, I have the wall sinking in, but just a little bit, so it's, you can almost see the outline, so you see where it goes in and it's kind of faded right there. There it is. So, but when it's faded like that, it means you're not going to be able to see it. The reason being is you have to be, with a few of the walls, you can see that one there, with the windows rather, you have to get it perfectly placed or you're going to have it sticking on the outside. Now, you could have it, and some of my buildings I do when the walls are really thin, actually have it so you have the inside of that, whatever wall structure you decide to use, actually inside the building. It does give you a nice flat surface to build upon, but I just kind of preference, I wanted to do this one properly. And a quick note as well, you know, notice those first couple of walls I did, that when I placed the rug down and held X, the wall would snap to the left or the right or forward and back. Now, I actually knew how to do this, and I deliberately did it the wrong way first. If you put the rug down first, you're then going to... So you notice I put the wall down, then the rug, and I hold X and it moves perfectly. If you put the rug down first and then the wall, when you hold X, the wall, your positioning will snap back forward and left. If you go back to the start of the video, you'll see it. And it makes it really awkward. If you accidentally do that, just pick the rug up and place it back down again. It's just a weird little thing that happens when you put the rug down. Rug down first. The reason why I accidentally discovered this is obviously, you notice when you open up your menu, it defaults to your last tab. So I would, you know, put the wall down, then the rug, and then I would alternate depending on what was the last selected item. So I am doing the entire inside. This is actually quite a short one, I think, because I'm times twoing the speed. It's only just under 20 minutes. I was a bit conscious of it being a little bit tedious, but it turned out I'm quite quick at doing this now. So I double boarded this one. I usually don't. I was doing this thinking, oh, it's not going to fit in. I'm going to have it. Because just the fact is that where I grabbed the rug might be in the wrong place. But it squeezed in nicely, which saved me some time. You may notice as well, I'm also placing all of the walls down first. Just it saves me, you guys seeing me scrolling through the tab wheel so much. Now, just a quick note as well. Obviously, this isn't going to be as creative as a normal Let's Build video. It's just that I didn't really demonstrate how to, you know, I showed you guys how to make the, do the kind of showed you how to do it once, but didn't show you how the whole effect will look on the inside, and I haven't really done many kind of real kind of walkarounds. Also, people are always asking me for a Let's Build, you know, or can you do an entire build tutorial of Sanctuary? One, no, fuck off, that would take me bloody hours. I'd be editing that with bloody thing for a week. It would be like, oh good lord, no, just to this level, just doing all these fiddly little parts would just, no, I do this over, the same with Spectacle Island, but at the same time, pretty much I just do this in every single building. I'll probably eventually, on the kind of other Let's Build videos, we'll do things which you can then insert into your Sanctuary vid. So for example, I'm doing, maybe for example, piers, that kind of thing. Now, I also reinforce the insides as well, so there are loads of holes. The great thing is these kind of wall end parts that you use for those roof and wall pieces fit perfectly. Again, I'm going for the scrappy look. These were a little bit trickier because they're they've got that thick pole through the center, which can sometimes be a bit fiddly, but for the outside wall it was a bit tricky, but these ones they squeezed in quite nicely, and I was quite pleased. I didn't expect the, I thought the corrugated metal, I thought I'd, to be frank, I thought I'd kind of have to redo the entire video again. In case you guys don't know, I actually was meant to have this for you last night, and then you were going to get a Don't Starve video today. What happened was, is I had recorded all of this, or done similar to this, and forgot to turn off the jukeboxes in my settlement. So I was actually having classical music playing. Unfortunately, that music is copyrighted, and I got, fortunately, an automated email, clearly because it's a very popular song, YouTube recognised it, but basically it meant that I didn't want to risking a strike because I would have been kicked out of my network straight away. So I just deleted everything, posted a little announcement on Twitter, and also posted in the description of the Don't Starve vid, yeah, sorry, tomorrow. But oh, it's up now, so it's all grand. And hopefully, obviously I'll try and upload most days, but you know, some days I'll be drunk or something, I guess, or I don't know, chemmed up in a corner somewhere, not really knowing where I am. So you'll have to put up with that, I'm afraid. Forgive me, internet, forgive me. So now the walls are done, we can get to the, I say, exciting part. Now, basically, this is really simple. Well, okay, it's not at all. You see, I'm slowly moving the boards around, and it flashes. Right, I can now push it in. When I place one in, get them as high as you can, because they're always those top corners, and you literally snap them together. And that's literally how you get those on. Now, a quick note, the reason I initially was going to do this on the house opposite the Soul Survivor, so I like to think of it as the workshop house. That is the one house, that house right at the end that I showed you at the start, that is the one house that for some reason is very tricky to do this. It's just awkward. It's just the shape of the house, for some reason it just, they don't snap in. Now, I like showing this, so I put the, because this is my little, my favourite little stairs, shall we say, so it's basically a doorway, stairs, two boards, another stairs, and then we get to the bridge, and we just raise it, get it so it's in the red, and so it's perfectly level, and then just slowly sink it down. The reason being is you want to get the bridge on, make sure it's a little bit lower, you don't want it touching too much, because you can't, see I'm testing it, I can't place on one of the railings, And the railings are what will hide that gap a little bit at the top. Let's move it down a wee bit. And there we go. It's on. It's always at the back for some reason. Do the alternating railings. Repetition, repetition. And now we're on the top. And then it's just pretty much straightforward, really. Now I've got all of the shack foundations in. I just snap them in. The great thing about this is you notice I'm not even worrying about that chimney because I'm just going to build around it. Now I'm going to do, before I do anything else, I'm going to do the... Because I would put wheel mills in. So the same kind of function here. This one was a bit fiddlier to get in. But it's just about moving it and it'll flash. It will always go in. Unless you've done something weird or, I don't know, life just hates you, it will go in. It just takes a little bit of patience. The reason, for those of you guys who've watched my Let's Build videos, you know the reason why I do this is because putting a shack foundation in just makes the windmills look a lot more secure, and it just adds a little bit more depth to them, because they've got those weird spindly little legs. I don't like them so much. So then we go to the windmill, looking grand. The great thing is even that's buried into the shack foundation doesn't actually block the wire. For my preference, I always have a nice switched on pylon. I like the idea there's an on-off switch for each house. It just creates some problems if I want loads of generators to power defences, but that's a fun challenge. Just checking the outside now. So right, now we're doing the top. Now I wanted to cover up the chimney. There is a little bit of a peek through, like a bit of the roof is peeking through. Sometimes that'll just happen. If you were really obsessive, I wasn't too bothered because I know I was going to put a staircase there later. But you could, for example, just remove the entire roof and then just try it again. But I just didn't want to put you guys through that. Or you can cover it with, because of that, the thing with the walls, because they're not, the ceiling, the roofs rather, because they're not actually, almost don't count structures for placing items. You could probably just put a table over it, to be honest, or any kind of desk. Quick note as well, you may notice the weather gets very grey very quickly. For some reason, this just... I'm in a weird season in the game, and I had to keep either reloading or just kind of like basically stopping recording and then going to sleep, because I kept getting either rain or nuclear storms. I'm like, I think I had all of the rain and all of the nuclear storms in one period. So what I wanted to do with this top part is I wanted to have a little bit of a flat roof like that. Some amazing YouTuber who's, I keep forgetting to remember people's names, I give them shout outs. Sorry, dude. It was in one of my... It was in, I believe, my Let's Build for my second one. They mentioned that using... Because I'm using the shack roofs, but normally I use the thinner ones. I'm actually using the thicker ones. The reason being is because I'm going to put railings on the top. And putting these ones on means that they're actually the same height as the railings. So it's a really good thing. So if you're having those roofs next to kind of flat ceilings, so you have kind of an upper level with just railings, always use the thick ones because they're almost exactly, if not exactly, the same height. See how crappy the weather gets? It's getting dark now, actually, but it just gets nuclear storms and rain. It was a pain in my bloody ass. I had to wait for 4 days just to do the bloody walk around. So there we go. Up we go. So pretty much, it's really straightforward. I know this is maybe the most creative video, but it's... For a lot of you, this will be the only settlement you're actually really going to build on. You might build in one other, but you'll genuinely be keeping Sanctuary. Now, I decided to move my Shakaba floors forward, because I realised that from the front of the house, once I put the railings on, you wouldn't actually be able to see the railings. I liked the idea that you could see the upper floor, so I decided to just kind of move it forward again. I think I eventually just make it... Yeah, no, I do. I just end up scrapping my whole idea and just kind of making it so it's really long. So we go, off get the rain. I put these in, and then I change my mind in a bit. Not yet. Oh, quick note with these walls. They sometimes, you know, so they struggle to fit in. Always do a corner last. So start from a corner and move sideways. Sometimes I get impatient, and I just end up just kind of placing them in random orders. I notice that what happens is it's easier for them to snap in a corner rather than in between. So say I place, like... Save for those four, and I'd done both of the corners and one of the center two. It would be really awkward for me to actually snap the roof in. Then go. Also, with those doorways, putting the wall ends rather. If there's a doorway there or one of the walls that actually kind of go out the same as the doorway, you have to take that wall off before you can put anything kind of, I guess, next to it, because it's just quite a thick surface. So it's done, I think. We're going to do the doorway in a sec. What are you doing now? What are you doing, David? Oh, yeah, I'm doing the power. That's right. I'm getting more tidier, because this is going to be Sanctuary 2.0. I'm not going to lie, you're probably not going to get the Sanctuary 2.0 video for a long time, because I'm doing it while I'm playing the game. It's fun, but as you can imagine, this took me 40 minutes to do just one of these, and that wasn't including, by the way, the decoration. So this video was 40 minutes, and I've sped it up. I think it takes me about almost an hour and a half, I guess, to do each building, and that's a lot of building, to do the same building over and over again. So you'll get Sanctuary 2.0 eventually. Maybe I'll have the inspired one then, do it in one big go. But we've got time, we've got loads of other settlements. Gonna be doing Jamaica Plains next, by the way, spoiler, because I want to make a shanty town in the middle of a city, well, a small city. So yeah, just putting the power pylons on. I'm being more, getting more tidy with my cables. So in my original Sanctuary video, they look cool and I love having cables everywhere, but sometimes they were going over stairs. So I'm a bit more conscious now of actually making them just not strangle you as you're going down. So yeah, just placing my power pylons on, really. I'm also maybe using a few less of the big pylons. I love having them. It's just that I want to have lots of them, but maybe not make them kind of some of them superfluous, but for this one I only had two, but often I usually try and have three, just because you can put lights on them. See, it's getting foggy already. Seriously, it was an absolute nightmare. So just running up there. I do decorate this one as well, don't worry. I don't do it in the video, but you will see it decorated to a piece. I'm gonna actually put the doorway in, and I'd forgotten to do it, so you'll see it half decorated before I then do the walk around. Just making the powers in again. I'm trying to because normally I would actually use the power conduits instead of the pylons, but I decided to just kind of use the little pylons a little more, because that way the little conduits don't end up going, crossing over too many areas, because man, I'm going to put a little power station in there. So there we go. Now we do the doorway. Now basically, the reason why I did the doorway, and I fiddle with this a little bit, is it was sticking in. Now I prefer these kind of doors, I just like the kind of scrappy look, because the house is covered in wood. So I tried to do it with the back first. I was like, right. Then I remembered something. And basically what I did, just to help me put a surface down, is I put a few small floors down to help me. Most of the doorways, you notice in my first tutorial, it was really easy for me to sink the doorway in. Some houses, for whatever reason, it's harder. See, this one is much trickier. So I kind of lined the doorway at first, using the door and the white wood on the side to actually get it straight-ish. It's a bit bad, but you notice it's faded. So there you go. Now, you notice it's sticking out. It looks a bit weird. Haha. But I've got a plan. Put the shack floors up. These stairs are the coolest. And now I have a little decking at the front. See, that's why I put the wood on, because I just think it adds a bit more texture to the yard. This is a personal aesthetic choice on my end. I said, I'm not going to... I don't exactly haven't tried it myself. I think I tried it once to kind of sink the doorways in. But basically, you can actually use the other technique, which is in the comments section of loads of my videos. Right, here's the walk around, guys. That's it. It was a pretty short, about 18 minutes long. Hope you found that helpful, and I'm going to sign off there. And there'll be a Don't Starve vid tomorrow, and then hopefully Jamaica Plain the day afterwards. You take care. Bye.
Always glad to see the sun come up one more time.